I said last week I wasn't planning on making a ton of videos about the NFL playoffs, but my God, how incredible has this postseason been. But this is not like my video after the wildcard round where I just dumped some of my thoughts out there. No, this week, I noticed a trend. Something that can explain what many of us know, but can't quite articulate. In this video, we're discussing why running quarterbacks can't work in the NFL. At least not. I had to clickbait you a little bit there, or as they would call it in the journalism school, which I paid a lot of money for, a well-constructed tease. But I do really think I found the key to this question we've all been asking. And I think we all know what inspired this particular late-night researching binge. The Tennessee Titans beating the NFL's best team, the Baltimore Ravens, at home. It was one of the more shocking results of the last decade. And no, that's not a cheeky joke that, oh, it's 2020, it's a new decade. And don't try to tell me that you knew this was coming. No one did, at least according to Vegas. And just to be clear, this is not a video quote-unquote exposing Lamar Jackson. I want Lamar Jackson and his style of play to work long-term in the NFL. And I, as well as all of you, I'm sure, am tired of the so-called pundits on TV telling me why that style of quarterback won't work, using general arguments about injuries and defenses figuring him out. But I found what I believe to be the actual reason why right now a running quarterback on his own cannot win a Super Bowl in the NFL in today's game. Quick qualifier before we get started, no matter what I say here, that doesn't change the fact I believe a quarterback's mobility is one of the most useful tools he can have. Whether it's Wilson, Rodgers, Mahomes, or Watson, in today's game, a quarterback has to at least have a baseline level of mobility. So this is not me opining for the days of Montana, Fouts, or Starr. Let's begin to answer my question with a question. Have you ever wondered why a Major League Baseball pitcher can't also hit every day in the lineup? I mean, yes, we all have jokes about how Madison Bumgarner should be in the Home Run Derby, or back in the day, Carlos Zambrano was better than half his own lineup, but that's all they are. They're jokes. A pitcher couldn't really hit at the level of his field-playing teammates, but why? Well, simply put, hitting is hard. Pitching is hard. It takes a lot of practice, study, and, most importantly, repetition to become proficient at these things. Isn't throwing a football at an NFL level hard? Isn't being an NFL running back hard? Don't both of those things require lots of practice, study, and reps? But don't worry, that's not my reasoning. That's just some context for the rest of the arguments I'll be making. For my arguments, I'll be referencing Lamar Jackson and the Ravens, the aforementioned genesis of this very video. Jackson will no doubt be the NFL MVP for the 2019 season, or already has been depending on when you're watching. Hi, futurely overly critical grip. He's possibly the most successful running quarterback in history. He broke the record for most rushing yards by a quarterback, was the leading rusher in the league's most prolific rushing offense, and finished 8th overall in the league in rushing yards while playing one fewer game than his contemporaries. This guy was basically a running back playing the quarterback position, and I mean that almost literally. The Ravens threw fewer passes than any team in the league during the regular season. That time frame is very important, by the way, and therefore clocked in at only 27th in total passing yards. Yet Jackson still led in passing touchdowns. This is the modern running quarterback in a nutshell. Jackson led the league's most potent rushing attack, opening up the defense for the play-action pass, which he used to great effect, especially in the red zone. The Ravens' offense was so dynamic, they couldn't be stopped. They ripped off 12 straight wins in the regular season while never scoring fewer than 20 points. Almost more importantly, they never gave up more than 23 points in that span and held the opposition to single digits twice. Why is that important? Because that's what the Ravens and modern running quarterbacks do to teams. They keep opposing defenses on the field, beat them down with a multi-pronged rushing attack, and are nearly impossible to come from behind against, since they can grind the game down to an absolute halt. When called upon, they're explosive in both the run and pass games, as evidenced by the Ravens' 6.1 yards per play average. Enter the Tennessee Titans. Now, you may justifiably think the Titans' victory was just a natural part of the NFL playoffs. It's crazy and random. On any given day, any team can win. But I don't think so. I think the Titans came in with a game plan and an ability to execute that game plan that is perfectly designed to beat a running quarterback. Let's start with how the Ravens finished the game, and then we'll take a look at how they got there. Lamar Jackson finished with 59 passing attempts, nearly double his season average. Baltimore finished with just 29 rushing attempts, compared to their 37 attempts per game average, and finished with 185 rushing yards. Now, in the regular season, they had six games with fewer yards than that on the ground. Of those six, they lost one, went to OT in one, and the rest were against the 49ers, Bills, Cardinals, and Bengals. So here's what we know. The Ravens had to throw more than they had all season. Jackson's previous season high was 43 attempts. They lost that game, by the way. And they ran far less than they're used to. The Ravens are not equipped to throw that number of times in a game. Yes, they have solid weapons at receiver and tight end. Yes, they have a good pass-blocking O-line. But Lamar Jackson literally isn't good enough to throw 59 times in a game. Now, that sounds like I'm hating on Lamar Jackson. I'm not. Think to yourself, how many quarterbacks are good enough to throw 60 times in a game against a playoff team and win? I can think of maybe three or four. The Ravens were never designed to do this. Because the other piece of this game is that thing that we hear about from pundits and coaches so much, it's starting to hurt our ears. Turnovers. The Ravens turned the ball over three times, tied for their season high. All three of those turnovers were Lamar Jackson's. He threw two picks and fumbled once. The fact it was Jackson is important. I'm not just bringing that up to slander it. The Ravens are not used to playing from behind. They grind teams down, and they do it by absolutely breaking your back, like I said. They average more plays per drive than anyone else, more yards on those drives, and they average the longest drives in the NFL. The Titans prevented all of that. Derrick Henry was so good, and the Titans stuck to their game plan for so long, they broke the Ravens' back. Baltimore's offense simply doesn't work when they have to throw as much as they did. Jackson turned the ball over more, the Titans chewed a bunch of clock in key situations, and the Ravens had to play from behind all game. But all of this sounds like outlier stats from one game. I'm saying this is how running QBs get beat. When you hear that tired adage, defenses will figure him out, this is what that actually looks like. It doesn't mean defenses will learn how to be faster and tackle better. Ask Emmitt Smith or Barry Sanders whether that ever happened. It means an offense that is so high octane and precise will fail when put under stress. Ever wonder why they don't enter NASCAR cars in Le Mans? NASCARs aren't built for that. The Ravens' offense, which is so polished and pristine and well-built, was not built to play from behind against a ground-and-pound old-school football team. This is the core problem with running quarterbacks. Just like pitchers in the major leagues, it's hard to do it all. The more time Jackson focuses on his running game, the less time he has for his passing game. And yes, his running game takes study and practice. It's not just him throwing together mad dash scrambles that he breaks for a bunch of yards like Michael Vick used to. According to Pro Football Focus, 65% of Jackson's rushing yards as of week 15 came from designed running plays. 116 of his 151 carries up to that point were designed, 77%. Jackson was more of a true running back than any quarterback we've seen. And that takes game planning and practice. But then that takes away from his ability as a thrower, naturally. There are only so many hours in a day. Every hour Jackson works on his running game is an hour he loses working on his passing game. And when his passing game gets called into question, he's less able to generate offense with that than with his legs. The Titans made him throw, so he turned the ball over and let the Titans chew all his time off the clock. But sports evolve. You've probably been saying, well, Griff, what about Shohei Ohtani? He can do it all. And you're right. I haven't mentioned Shohei Ohtani. In 2018, Ohtani hit .285 with 22 homers and 61 RBIs and added 51 and two-thirds innings pitched, where he compiled a 4-2 record with a 3.31 ERA and 63 Ks. Ohtani is the closest we've seen to the true hitting pitcher in over half a century. Sports evolve. Guys get better, more athletic. Training gets better and more efficient, keeping guys healthier and giving them more time for practice. Does my argument today mean that there will never be a college-style running quarterback in the NFL? Absolutely not. Just 20 years ago, we never thought anything but a pocket passer would ever succeed in the NFL. Steve Young was an anomaly, and Vic was injury-prone because of his playstyle. Now pretty much all the best quarterbacks in the league are mobile, and mobility is one of the most coveted traits for a QB prospect. yes, I believe one day there will be a quarterback that can throw the ball and run the ball in equal measure and be great at both. Maybe that guy will be Lamar Jackson, and maybe it'll be next year. I hope it is. And here's hoping one of you out there is the coach or the trainer that finally makes the true running quarterback mainstream. We appreciate you watching.